but if they are defeated, we will ally Italy and Romania again. So Turkey has been forced back into one area despite having like 8 areas at one point. Bulgaria too had a lot of areas. Started with 2, I believe. Then I gave them Belgrade and another area. So they were pretty strong, but and they took Istanbul, so. Alright, we have a diplomat here. Speak to the Italian Empire again.
Left-click on the listed offer and demand items to
map information is all we want currently. As Bulgaria isn't defeated yet. So we got some updated map information. They still hold one area in Africa. The area of Mogadishu. So the Axis are almost defeated in Africa. Turkey still seems to be holding this area. Palermo. So they still have one area if they lose Izmir. One area all over, all the way over here. Alright. Soviet Union have surprised the world and gone and taken areas from Turkey. Okay, the Romanians seem to still be holding their territory. I need this diplomat to move down here. Don't have an eye on that region. And this could move down here. Don't need the spy all the way over there. This place are there. The Soviet Union have become pretty huge. They are way bigger than they were in the start of the game, while we are way weaker and smaller. And almost insignificant. Still holding Western Europe, but everything else have been lost. Scandinavia too. We are still holding Scandinavia too. Okay. Infantry can't do much anyway. But we will send the infantry up to Paris. Keep 4 units of riflemen in Rouen. The general could be kept there, but I think we'll move him to Paris too. So 4 units of riflemen in Rouen. 2 units in Bordeaux. Could move 1 unit down to Bordeaux. We have 3 in both areas. Actually, we can move even another one to Bordeaux, 4 there. I like having 4 in every place. And in Rouen we have 2. Let's move two from Bristol to Rouen. And can move some elite stuff. Two riflemen to Bristol, so we have 4 there as well. Here we have 5. Frankfurt has more than 5. Okay, move the infantry, elite infantry to Paris. So three units in Frankfurt. Alright, that's fine. Now let's take a look at the recruitment and building. So we're constructing a shipwright in Berlin. One turn left until it's completed. Okay, and in Frankfurt we can upgrade the city from a minor city to a large city. We will do that. And we have no shortage of money. We have 307,183. We can build a medium tank factory in Amsterdam, so we'll do that. And in Paris, we have some choices. 5 turns, 4 turns, 6 turns, 4 turns. Alright, I think we'll go for the medium tank factory, actually, in Paris. We're back in Berlin. Now let's take a look at recruitment. So in Berlin, we'll still continue to construct Tiger 1s, as we can't do that from any other region currently. Hamburg, we are constructing the Messerschmitt 109 fighters. In Oslo, we'll get another Assault Infantry as usual. And then we're already constructing planes in many areas. We don't need to construct anything there. May have missed something there, didn't I? Know I was constructing Messerschmitts. Alright, Assault Infantry in Copenhagen. And we're back in Berlin. Next turn. Turkey has sent a diplomat to Vienna. They want an alliance. Their enemy is the Soviet Union. I am going to accept the alliance. Sure. Alright, end of turn report. We are still going well economically. Okay, faction announcements. Alright, a new family member, Lucy. And Erwin Rommel, mathematician, plus one management. Construction complete, the shipwright in Berlin. Recruitment report, we have a new UA-88 plane in Frankfurt, and we have new Assault Infantry and Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Diplomatic information, the following factions are now at war with each other. The British Commonwealth of Nations have declared war on Hungary, and the French Republic on Turkey. Following factions have declared that they are allies, the French Republic and Portugal and Turkey and the Third Reich. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. The Italian Empire and Hungary have declared a ceasefire with the French Republic. Alright. Let's move this diplomat up. I don't like not knowing what's happening over here. Oh, a Soviet army is outside of Stettin. Lots of planes. Alright. Let's move this Assault Infantry unit back to Frankfurt and the Panzer Force too. So we can move in this plane unit into Stettin to defend. And this army will be outside of Berlin to back up the capital if it's attacked. Right, and let's move the Assault Infantry to Frankfurt and move a unit of planes to Stettin instead. Alright, how many Assault Infantry did we have here? I believe 8. So we'll move 8 of the riflemen from this area. Alright, we already had units there. So move out the plane and move in all the infantry. So München is defended by a lot of infantry. Let's move this infantry towards Frankfurt, where they still can be placed. And the plane will be moved to Vienna to defend. Alright, we move in the SLT infantry here. We have some better force there now. They are at the front line. All the SLT, the riflemen could be moved. Alright, had a lot of SLT infantry here. Let's move all the riflemen. Alright. Looking better, but I believe Prague is kind of weak compared to the other areas there. Need to move out another rifleman unit if there is any. We have one unit here of riflemen left. Let's move him out. Then we will move assault infantry. I believe we will move one from Prague. And then we can move the one unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighters to Prague. So we get another one. And we move the U-88 heavy bombers to Berlin. We have 4 units of U-88 heavy bombers in Berlin now. Ah, the plane, the tanks could also be moved to Prague. Let's move these to Frankfurt. 2 units of SLT infantry. And move the Panzer Force to Prague instead. Now they are a little stronger. 5, 6. Alright. Riflemen are almost worthless. In any other role than garrisoning cities anyway. Plane in Bordeaux that we can move up. And in Paris. Probably in Rouen as well. And in Brussels. And then Amsterdam. Let's move the SLT infantry to Frankfurt. And another plane to Stettin. Alright, so I moved out everything good there in Amsterdam. Copenhagen and Oslo can only recruit infantry anyway. Now let's move out the infantry here. The more SLT infantry sent there. Move back the planes before the British attack. Lots of infantry. Their army is outside of Stettin already. Alright, but we are prepared to fight. To defend the cities. Berlin is heavily defended too. Outside of the US. Hungary we have here. We have the United States. Let's see if the map has changed.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Need map information.
A balanced or very generous treaty.
Yeah, the map has changed. Vichy France has retaken areas in Africa. I think. Yeah, they have. Bamako has been retaken. And Niamey is held by the French Republic. Alright, so Vichy France has done some good job there. Retaken Dakar as well. And they're still holding Nakhchot. Nakhchot. Alright. The good news in Africa for the Vichy French, but in Turkey things are not good, and on our front things are not good either, even though we have bolstered our defenses, still are at a disadvantage, I believe. They can just make more armies. Okay, I think we'll place this force close to Berlin, probably. We have lots of armies in Berlin if it's attacked. Let's check the agents. Don't think we need a spy over there anymore. Let's move her down here. So we have Soviet armies inside of Hungary now. They might just be trespassing in order to enter our areas. Because we have a border there. They might go this way to attack Prague or Vienna. They seem to ignore Romania. A diplomat in Spain, of course. Spy here. We move that spy. We can't move her closer. Okay. Alright, she'll stay there. I have a spy here too. Let's move it next to this army. Oh shit, it's only a lot of planes. Isn't too good. Then I know what I should do. Let's attack with the planes. I can't this time. We've already moved a lot of the planes. Some of them could move out. A lot of them actually. Alright, most of them could move out. They had 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 MiG-3s and 2 Jack-9s. It's 11 planes in total. Let's battle on the battle map. Actually, I changed my mind. I think we will just attack with the Great Army. Fight the battle on the battle map. Start deployment. So there will be a air battle. An air battle this time. Alright, start the battle, pause the game. See the little black dots that we need to click on here. Thanks to the forest. Alright. It's not impossible. We had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 versus 11, alright. But we have the better planes. Even though they had almost no unit losses and we had about half the strength. We have 12 instead of 24. Alright, start the battle. They had the upper ground. I don't like the trees. Their allied force doesn't seem to do much. Fortunately. Fast forward, otherwise it will take forever. Otherwise, don't have time to wait.
Unser schwachköpfiger General hat sein Leben weggeworfen und vielleicht unsere Chance auf Sieg gleich mit.
We lost the captain. They might actually win this fight. 26. Let's place them under AI control. Alright, so we have lost 29%, they've lost 9%. Shit. That's not good. means the city is undefended from the air. They wanted to take out their airplane force before they could send more troops. Problem was they had full-sized units and we had only half-sized units. That's why they won. Also they had the upper ground, which probably is to their advantage. It wasn't a good terrain either. With these hills and trees and everything. Right, 12% and 2%. Better to keep the air force in the city, probably. I won't replay it too. I decided to attack, so the air force is lost. Still have one unused unit in the city that we couldn't move out, and maybe some of them will retreat there. Now they are at a clear disadvantage when the Soviet army will attack. Some of the planes from the army too. They seem to have total numerical advantage in the air. No wonder why we lost this battle. I also believe the hills helped them a lot. So, men deployed. Captain Hugo had 217, men killed 42, and remaining 115. Captain Adolf, 25 men deployed, 3 kills, 13 remaining. Captain Arseniy had 265 men killed, 111, men remaining 217. The terrain was on their side. Alright, we lost the battle. Some of the planes will retreat to Stettin, I believe. We'll see.
Verlassen die Armee, Kaiser.
Not good. Large town, east wall, cobblestone road, trader, medium caserne, medium tank factory, civil headquarters, small park, farms one, port, airstrip, mortar training ground. Not the most highly advanced city. We lost almost all the planes now. So we will do do this. Unfortunately, we need to take from this army to defend Stettin. Alright. So, this guy has a new air force. Has arrived here. They will defend. Now this army needs plane. We need planes for this force now. Let's move to this unit then. Okay. We can't do much more this time. I want to know where the other diplomats are on the map. We have one in Africa and one in Spain. Where are the others? One in Romania, one in Libya. Alright, one in Romania. Would be nice if it did speak to Turkey. What could we do with Turkey there? I don't know. Speak to Romania, it was a long time ago.
Left click on the listed offer and demand
items. How map information.
Left click on an item in the proposal to
map information.
A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
Alright, done. And speak to Hungary. It was a long time ago too.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous.
Alright, so we have updated information over here. Italy has become very strong. Hungary still has 3 regions. I wonder who is at war with Bulgaria. So Italy and Romania. Can't declare war on them, then my other allies might actually not trust me and break the alliance with me because I broke their alliance. Yep. I can't do that. Which factions are my other allies allied to? Spain is allied to Italy. They can't attack Italy. Turkey is allied to Hungary. We are also allied with Hungary, so that's fine. Japan is allied to India, South Reich, Thailand, and the Italian Empire. French state Vichy is allied to the Italian Empire. Bulgaria is allied to the Reich. All right, so we could attack Romania. The Soviet army is moving through the Hungarian lands there. Ah, we are no longer holding Warsaw. Send a Stuka tactical bomber towards Romania. Need a war so we can force them into becoming a vassal. That way they are allied so the Soviets will attack them too. Alright, next turn. I might have forgotten to do the buildings and recruitment. But no matter. Yeah, I probably forgot, I'm an idiot. I will not load because then the tanks might get all fucked over. That wasn't good. Actually, I might use the... No, I won't. So we can build a dockyard in Berlin. Army headquarters. Let's build the army headquarters. And wait a second, it will take 5 turns. Dockyard will also take 5 turns. Will enable us to build a Bismarck, but we don't need ships. Stokes, mortars, Hummels, etc. Army headquarters. I want them to be built when the Battle of Berlin is fought, so yeah. We go for that. Berlin. Let's check the other cities, what we can construct there. Don't have a lot of cities anymore. Alright, nothing else could be constructed this time. Let's build another Tiger One in Berlin. And then some more Messerschmitts, as we lost a lot of them. Still the infantry in Oslo. Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes in München. Frankfurt will go for the U-88 heavy bombers. And in Amsterdam, the Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Same in Brussels. And in Paris. And Rouen. And in Bordeaux. And in Vienna. And in Prague. Stettin. And in Copenhagen. We're back in Berlin, alright. Soviet army is still outside. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. French Republic has declared war on Hungary. Following factions have declared they are allies. Portugal and the United Soviet Socialist Republic of the Soviet Union has declared an alliance. Following factions have declared a ceasefire. The Italian Empire and the French Republic and Hungary and the British Commonwealth of Nations. Unit recruitment completed. We have a new Tiger One in Berlin. And end of turn report. Yeah. Another Tiger One to be added to this army. We move this plane unit to the army too. Alright. This infantry unit could be moved all the way to Berlin. Help defend the city if it's attacked. Let's attack Romania. War, so Russia and Romania. Okay. Romania.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a
map information. Map information, become a protectorate.
A balanced or very generous
attack faction, the Soviet Union. We will attack the faction, the Soviet Union. Alright. That's done. Lines announced, Romania and the Third Reich. Ceasefire in effect, Romania and Bulgaria. Frank Kingdom established, the Third Reich in Romania. Alright. Now we just need to move the plane out of there. I want the Soviets to attack Romania. So we get some pressure off of ourselves. one free slot there. Let's move a plane. We'll move the plane to this army instead. We need it to be back at full strength. Move the rifleman to Frankfurt. Yes. Another plane could be moved to the army too. Sized army. Alright, and only infantry over here. Four riflemen in each of those three settlements. Right, so Frankfurt is ready there. Can't move them now.
Mein Kaiser? Ja, mein Kaiser.
Don't want to move them from Hamburg in case they attack Hamburg instead.
Ja, mein Kaiser. Ja, mein Kaiser.
Move some assault infantry too. From Copenhagen. And we can move the ships back to the port of Copenhagen. Right, so we have two vassals, Hungary and Romania. Might break if they are attacked by one of the other factions. For example, if Italy is attacking one of them, then we might need to attack Italy. Alright, next turn. End of turn report. Still good in economy. Faction announcements. Marriage celebrations. Hans Bush and marriage celebrations. George Becker. Alright. Recruitment report in Vienna, Copenhagen, Oslo. We have new assault infantry. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. British Commonwealth of Nations and the Soviet Union have declared war on Hungary, our vassal. And the following factions have declared a ceasefire. The Italian Empire has declared a ceasefire with the French Republic. And Hungary and Turkey has a ceasefire with the United States of America. Okay. So we have Soviet troops in Romania now. One army seems to be moving towards Odessa. Exactly what I wanted. So they have scout snipers, they have the Renault FT, worst tank of the French. They have Messerschmitt 109 fighters and EU-52s. Probably heavy bombers, they might be fighters. Transport aircraft, yeah. They're transport aircraft. They are also probably fighters or bombers, something of that sort. Okay, so the Soviets are moving towards Odessa with one army. And another one with three units of planes are moving towards their capital. And Romania has the faction leader in their capital. And assault infantry. Italian assault infantry, scout snipers, some units of anti-aircraft trucks, pack 40s, scout snipers, Messerschmitts. Alright. The anti-aircraft trucks are easily killed, that's why I don't build any of those and do planes instead. The Stukas are bad against fighters. The anti-aircraft trucks are supposed to fight fighter planes, but and bombers, but yeah, they're easily taken out, so I don't waste my resources on them. Okay, let's keep the Stuka here in case Bucharest is attacked. Then we can fight the battle together with the Romanian army. This army back, this unit back. We may have some planes we could send to Odessa, but won't do that. It's too far away. Alright, so the Soviet Union moved back their troops to the area of Poland. Didn't attack Stettin. Don't want these units to be added to any army. We move them outside of Berlin instead. This way we have more than one army defending the capital. We are probably still constructing stuff this time, so we have no planes to move to any of the armies or cities this time. And these areas are still defending. Move some SLT infantry to the ships. Move them towards mainland Germany. Reinforce this army here. Okay, spy could move up towards Soviet. Oh shit, they have a lot of planes in this army. No joke, they have aerial superiority. They have air superiority. Three great armies. We might be able to hold against one if we're lucky. Alright. Actually, we will move infantry here. We have four slots free. Some planes to Stettin. We need air superiority. In the city. So we have some pack 40s as well. We can move that army. And then we send the planes to Stettin. Alright. Now they are a lot stronger. Infantry. Tanks. For now we'll do this. We have tanks, artillery and infantry. And there is only infantry. Okay. No planes, but Berlin has a lot of planes, so... Alright. Let's move this spy here. Actually, we could use her there. We'll keep that spy there. It's good to see what is happening in Turkey too. They are an ally currently, so. Okay, we are done, but I need to build some stuff probably. Forgotten to do that. We have nothing to build. We are still constructing the Tiger 1 and some tanks. Right, in Oslo we will need to build a trooper ship because we couldn't recruit any troops this time. And in Copenhagen we'll go for assault infantry. Alright, next turn then. They are attacking Stettin now. Sergei Vorofilov is attacking Stettin with mostly planes. That's why I replaced a lot of infantry and pack 40s with actual planes. Air superiority in the battle. Save before the battle. Let's play the battle on the battlefield. Battle of Stettin. This is a large town. A Catholic church there. Civil headquarters. 0 damage. So it looks better. Alright. We have a medium tank factory here. It can also construct Panzer IVs. So this is the medium tank factory. Panzer IVs and Panzer I's and BMW motorcycles arrive from this place. Vanilla building a trader. It's a vanilla building even though this is a German town. A large town. So the trader is still a vanilla building in the large town. And we have the airstrip. Alright. Here we have the medium casern. Now let's prepare the troops. Okay, we will place the general at the center. And loose formation. Stuka tactical bomber will also be placed here. Loose formation. Then we'll group all the fighter planes. We'll place the tanks here too. Loose formation. Okay. transformation for the planes as well. We'll place them in the center. And we'll put them in guard mode and in other AI control. Alright, let's start the battle. So the Soviet Union are attacking Stettin, a German large town with lots of planes. Fortunately, we have a lot of planes too.
Unsere Mauern wurden von den Feinden eingenommen.
Bad. Forgot to place them in guard mode. Let's put them in close formation and move them back to the city center. So reinforcements too. Side of the city. We have a unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighters outside here. We're constructed just in time. Shame that we lost the entire air force that we had stationed in this city before when we attacked the planes outside of the city. If it weren't for that, we wouldn't have needed to move these planes here. Okay, balance of power. The balance of forces is evenly matched. Percentage enemies killed 22%, 23%. Percentage allies killed 5%. Right. Yeah, we will probably win this battle. That big cost, probably. They have a Jeep's bodyguard inside of the city, too. Enemy General Fallen, Sergei Voroshilov, is dead. Fast forward, zoom in on the mini-map. Right, and fast forward the battle. All the planes in the air. huge amount of planes on both sides. Okay, 45% enemies killed, 9% allies killed. Oh, the charge made the camera move up. Captured, building lost, so on and so forth. Tanks have been taken out. Only planes and the general's bodyguard remaining. Forty percent allies kill, 58% enemies kill. Here we have some generals. Here's the general. Here we have some bodyguards. There are two heaps left. This battle was a victory. The wonder how many more armies will attack immediately after this victory. Look at all the planes laying everywhere. The city. Both outside and inside. Alright, we lost 16%. They lost 65%. Wait a second. Remove the AI control, stop what you're doing, and attack this plane. I believe that's the only one left. Maybe more, but I think that's the only one. The entire Air Force has been ordered to take down this plane, this Soviet plane right here. Oh, it flew away. Now it might be easier to take it down. Hopefully it will be taken down soon. Yeah, and it got taken down and we won. Clear victory. So, Hans Busch had 427 men, killed 405, very good. Men remaining 354. Captain Gunther had 25 men, killed 9, 25 remaining. So all of his planes are remaining. Enemy army Sergei Voroshilov had 625 men, killed 74, 192 remaining. Detailed statistics. They attacked immediately, but they didn't assault the city this time, so I was lucky there. Candidate for adoption, benefactor Gunther Alterbang. Sure. Settlement besieged, Stettin. It's besieged by another army. Now they have weaker troops there. Lost a few fighter planes. They need two new units. I don't have space for that just now. Send a pack 40 to the reinforcement army. Two units outside of the city. Could use one more. Actually, send both of the pack 40s there and move these into the army here. You don't need a general there too. Let's move the plane there too. We have a general here, Erwin Rommel. don't need to move him. Let's move the general here instead. Alright, we move the plane to this army. The Gunter Alterbung. The reinforcements have been assembled outside of the city. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. United States and Hungary. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. Italian Empire and the French Republic. Agent detected. Portugal. Where? I see. They are spying on Bordeaux. End of turn report. The profits are still good. Faction destroyed. Turkey has been defeated. Our ally is crushed. This area turned into a rebel area. I see, and this is not, this is the Soviet Union. So the Soviet Union took Trabzon, but it's the British Empire that has taken the area of Ankara, the capital of Turkey. So Britain has taken that area because the British armies are here now. We have scout snipers. And we have a armored officer's car, some other troops they can't see, and another leader here, Brian Wavell, family member, and Valentin Holland, family member. Alright, so the British have taken Ankara, and we'll take Izmir soon from the rebels down here. But Turkey had quite the forces defending Izmir. I believe they either were defeated on the battlefield or someone must have taken this area. Enemy settlement. Yeah, an enemy has taken this area. And their leader probably was there, so that's why they turned into rebels here and lost their troops at Veer in Izmir. So recruitment report. New Tiger unit, U-88. Have a bomber unit and the usual Messerschmitts and assault infantry. Construction report. In Frankfurt we have a large city now. Frankfurt has become a large city. As you can see here, a large city. And Amsterdam has a medium tank factory as well as Paris. Yeah, and faction announcements. New family member, Heinz Busch. Retinue expands, George Becker. Historian plus one command. Eval Jaeger, retinue expands. Desert Scout plus one command, alright. So Britain is now bordering Bulgaria soon. I'm not happy that Turkey was defeated like that. They had quite the forces here that could have easily held out for a while, but their leader probably was killed here. Okay, these armies will defend Berlin as reinforcements. Send another plane there to reinforce Stettin. Another one. I have a bomber now. We'll move. Could move a Stuka tactical bomber, but I don't want that. We move the Messerschmitts to that army. The U-88 into Berlin. We have five such planes now. We have one Stuka here too. Can move some planes from Bordeaux. And all the other cities.
Unsere heutige Reise ist beendet.
From Bristol to... See here, some assault infantry. Bristol, we had a message with 109 fighter. All the assault infantry here could be moved. Now it's only riflemen in Hamburg. Attack the army outside instead. That was cowardly. I will probably withdraw. Alright, attack with two armies. Now they have the upper hand. T-34, MS-1, MiG-3s and Jack-9s. Seem to have the upper hand. Lot of infantry too. T-34-85. And the Katyusha. Katyusha. Alright. Luka Noviko and Vladimir Kretschow. Alright, let's save the game. Might win this, but we could lose too. We have no backup, because I fled with the backup. They were smart enough to attack the reinforcing army. I didn't want to fight outside of the city. Fight the battle on the battle map. deployment. Right, balance of forces is evenly matched. But they have another army. Ah, their tanks are broken. And they have some really sucky tanks too. So move the general to the center. This time he will also be in guard mode. Tanks will be moved here too. Loose formation. And they could also be in guard mode. Panzer force. Alright, and then the planes will be in loose formation and in guard mode, and we will group them. Start the battle. Alright, so the army is already storming the bunkers. Already past the bunker cannons. Planes too, from this side at least. The greater army was on this side. Here they enter with Katyushas and tanks. Took out some of them. Took out one of their Katyushas too. Infantry from this side. Oh, we took down a plane with a bunker. Nice. Most of their troops managed to enter the city. The rocket trucks. The panzers have moved out from the plaza. Seem to be leading the battle. Victory is a distant possibility. 22% allies killed and 47% enemies killed. They had a lot of riflemen. That's why we seem to be winning. Our bunkers killed a lot of their infantry and stuff. Didn't help that they had two armies and scared away our reinforcements too. Yeah, this is a clear victory. So 7% allies killed, 56% enemies killed. Problem is we will lose a lot of planes. So we won't be able to hold for much more of this. Much longer. Air Force have been severely weakened after these two battles. So enemy general fallen, Vladimir Kreschov is dead. Building captured, gateway lost, captured, lost. Captured. Let's fast forward. Soviet Union has taken the plaza. Now we have taken it back. Alright. Enemy general fallen. Luka Novikov is also dead now. Both the generals of the Soviet Union has fallen. Oh, Captain Lev is dead too. Shit, they have taken the plaza. Seems to be constant battle of the plaza now.
Seht wie unser feiger Feind rennt! Zeigt den Angriff voranzutreiben!
We seem to have total superiority in the air, but they still have a few planes left. Let's pause the game for a while. I need them to go to the center and take it before it's too late. Take out the Soviet planes over there. bunker helped take out one of their planes there. Quite a few planes still in there. Uh, 55% allies killed, 72% enemies killed. Right, building lost, building captured, building lost. Captured, lost. Alright, it's time to move the troops. Take out their planes over here. Tired of this battle. So it will be taken out soon, I believe. I need to take out that plane. MiG-3 plane here. Yeah, took it out! Battle is over, I believe. Close victory. So we had Hans Busch had 175 men, killed 785, that's very good. Men remaining 87. Now we have very few left. Enemy army is Captain Lev at 128 men, killed 68, 49 remaining, so very good, probably plain army. Vladimir Khrushchev had 936 men, killed 34, 169 left, not very good for that army. Enemy win their battles from the air, they knock out my panzer with American armor-piercing shells. The conquered mourns, the conqueror is undone. Field Marshal Erwin Rommel. They attacked again, not good. The infantry isn't scary at all, but the planes are. So they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 MiG-3s and 1 Yak-9 with full strength. They're at full strength too. Let's save. But we will probably lose this battle. Our planes are too weak. Alright, let's fight the battle on the battle map anyway.
Zeit ist gekommen, Männer. Macht euren Kaiser stolz. Ihnen nach, Männer, für das Reich.
Start deployment. Let's place the general in the center. Loose formation and guard mode on. And then the planes will also be at the center. Loose formation and guard mode. We'll group them too. Alright, let's start the battle. Their planes will easily storm the bunkers. They had some infantry too. They will probably be easily killed. Some of the troops enter the city, so the infantry here are easily taken out by the planes at the center. So it will be a plane versus plane situation again. Balance of power. Balance of forces is evenly matched. 6% allies killed, 36% enemies killed. That's because we kill a lot of their infantry. They're already routing here. Might win this battle, but I'm not entirely sure. I'm entirely certain. 10% allies killed, 65% enemies killed. I think we'll win this battle. We can't hold against another one. We need to reinforce the city, or we will lose the city. Or a large town. Would lose probably, they have a lot of planes. There's a risk that we lose the battle, because they have a lot of planes. their strongest defenses outside of Berlin. The meter is on our side, 25% allies killed, 77% enemies killed. Might win. We could lose too. I think we'd win. Shit, they are at the center. Send some planes there. And the general. He will probably be killed. Too bright. You are leading, I think. Yeah, we will probably win. Right, 53% allies killed, 82% enemies killed. Hope they won't attack immediately after we have won the battle. Because we will lose if they have another one. Another big army attacking. Zoom in on the minimap. Right, so they have like one unit left. They have lost. And we won the battle. Awesome. Close victory. Hans Busch. Men deployed 81. Kill 470. Very good. Captain Alexei. 563 men. Kill 43. All right. Force the city. End of turn report. We are still going strongly with the economy. Town growth. München has a bigger population. War declared. French Republic and the Italian Empire. So München might be able to upgrade. Yeah, we can upgrade München to a city. We will do that. Frankfurt could get some new stuff. Let's so we can get the brick wall there and some other stuff. Stuka, all right. Leave the farms. We should already have those. I clicked the wrong button. This is Rome Total War. Alright, Frankfurt. Big park too. It's a civilian building. However, the rest. Complete in Frankfurt, we have a big park and farms plus 3. Alright, actually, the walls should already be there. Okay, let's build the army headquarters. Construct another U-88 heavy bomber. Let's go back to the building and look at the other cities. We are in Berlin. We have 2 turns left until we finish the army headquarters there. In Amsterdam we can build an aerodrome, which will enable us to get the U-88s from Amsterdam. We will do that. And in Paris, six turns, 5 turns, 4 turns. Let's build the aerodrome. It will enable us to get the U-88 heavy bombers. We are back in Berlin there. Let's take a look at the recruitment. In Berlin we will continue to build or construct Tiger Ones. Hamburg will construct Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Same in München. And in Amsterdam. As well as in Brussels. Paris will also do that. And in Rouen. In Bordeaux, assault infantry in Vienna, Messerschmitts in Prague, Messerschmitts in Stettin, assault infantry in Copenhagen. We're back in Berlin. So the retreated army will move into Stettin. At least the planes will move into Stettin. unfortunately we will need to move the planes from this army too. The artillery could be moved to the army again. Another plane unit could be moved to Stettin. I have two Soviet units here. Soviet army is there. Assault infantry will move into this army. Planes are reinforcing Stettin again. Alright, we don't need a general there. Oh, that the general moved in. Let's move other units back. Alright, what's the situation here? We need a full army in these cities. Okay. Can't move this, the planes there. Let's move the artillery there, actually. Okay. Could move infantry there. Get the full army there again. So Paris, we don't have a lot of stuff. Okay, mostly infantry in these areas. Don't have infantry there. British army are outside of Istanbul. They have a Matilda tank, 19 missile, 33 defense. Alright, they're a light tank. They've taken Izmir as expected. Full army there. Get some map information from the US. A lot could have happened.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Map information.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced order.
Yeah, they've taken back some areas in Africa from the Vichy France. From the Vichy French. They've taken this area now. Nouakchott. Wait a second. Nouakchott have been taken. The Vichy French are still holding Dakar. And the United States have taken this area back, Bamako, from the Vichy French. So Turkey was finally defeated. Bulgaria has a large city here. Family member and faction leader. Only a matter of time before Italy decides to finish them off, I think. The Soviet Union have taken two areas from Hungary. They've taken Uzhgorod from Hungary and Alba Iulia from Hungary as well. Budapest is now held by rebels. Which isn't good news.
Yeah.
Ah, so Hungary is defeated. Didn't know that. We only have Romania as a vassal now. Hungary and Turkey has been defeated. They are rebels now. That wasn't good news. Right, next turn soon then. We have an army here too. Let's move them to shore here. Alright, next turn. Italy finally took Sofia, the capital of Bulgaria, and Bulgaria is crushed. Faction destroyed Bulgaria. We lost our ally there too. And Italy is besieging Novi Sad. We can't attack this time. I need to send a diplomat. Italian Empire.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a
map information. Thank you. Why can't they become allied?
A balanced or very generous treaty.
That's annoying. So the Italian Empire. Republic, United Nations, USA, neutral, Spanish state. And very weird because we have the same allies, with the exception of Romania, but they are a protectorate, so we should be able to ally Italy. I don't know why that isn't the case. Soviets have taken two areas from Hungary. Italian faction are now in control over the entire Balkan area. They have Istanbul. Now they want this area, I guess. They want to unite the Roman Empire. They were strong enough to take Greece and Bulgaria. And Istanbul and Albania. Alright, recruitment report with two new SLT infantry units. Faction announcements. Alright, end of turn report. Alright, we are minus now, which isn't too good. Okay. Around here. I guess they turned around and attacked Hungary instead. We have Italy here as a wall. I want an alliance with Italy. I don't know why it isn't possible. Are they not our ally? Hmm. very weird that we can't ally Italy. We are allied with the Spanish state, we are allied with the Spanish state, we are allied with Japan, we are allied with Japan, we are allied with France, we are allied with France, they are allied with Romania, and we have Romania as a protectorate. Very weird. They are enemies. Alright, with the same factions we are enemies with. I don't understand why we can't ally the Italian Empire. Alright, let's move some infantry back. Moving the planes into Vienna again. We will break the siege and leave it to Italy instead. They will take both of those areas. Soviet is on their march towards Prague, a strong force. Good that Italy is about to face off against the Soviets there. Romania is still around. All the other smaller factions here have been destroyed. Britain will face off against Italian faction maybe, or even Soviet. We will see. Okay, we'll move some infantry back. Move the planes to the city instead. They're much more needed here. Brussels, we do not have any good stuff, same in Amsterdam, and in Hamburg, and in Frankfurt, Rouen, Audax, and in Paris, alright. Actually, Paris have some good infantry. Let's move the SS. Riflemen in Amsterdam had some assault infantry in Hamburg. We had some assault infantry here as well in München. build something. Construction menu here. Take a look at what we can build. Nothing. Then we will take a look at the recruitment. We will build a trooper ship in Oslo. In the port of Oslo. Or at the port of Oslo. Recruit some SLT infantry in Copenhagen. And we can't do more. Alright. Next turn. United Soviet Socialist Republics want us to be their protectorate. They can forget that. Alright. Could use some map information there.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
So we have more of the map visible in Asia as well. Asia. The Soviets attacked Prague. The strong army. They have air superiority. We will probably lose. The defending general is Ferdinand von Bock. And we have lots of infantry here. Some tanks. Alright, we will fight the battle. Have a reinforcing army too. Probably a unit of planes or something. Fight battle on the battle map. The war is probably lost. Could be lost. They seem to have an endless amount of armies with planes. We have limited numbers now. They have way more areas to recruit from too. Here we have a different type of wall. The brick wall, which is hard to enter for tanks and such, maybe even for planes, I think so. The general will be moved to the center. It'll lose formation and guard mode on. And rest of the troops will most likely be one group and lose formation and guard mode. Place them under AI assistance, maybe. Maybe not. Start the battle. We'll see how it will go. The towers are shooting machine gun fire at. Can't shoot through these walls. have some reinforcements too. Yeah, the airplanes. Messing with 109 fighter planes. Good. Attack from the outside. This wall is perfect when protecting the infantry at least. Good for infantry. I think the planes will be moved out. Can move out through this little gate, but it's very, very hard for them to do it. It's very, very narrow. I think it needs to be remade and made larger, otherwise they get stuck a lot of the time. They can move out. AI can also get stuck. It happened previously. Stuck like this. Few of them managed to get out, but the rest are stuck. Planes seem to have an easier time to get out. Some planes inside now. All right. Battle can end anyway. Right, so we have balance of power, balance of forces evenly matched, 24% allies killed, 41% enemies killed. We have killed more than they have. It's very equal, the meter.
Eingenommen.
is Vienna. I think it's Prague. Battle seemed to be turning against us. 28% allies killed and 44% enemies killed. Meter is slightly to our disadvantage. See if we can move them out. Planes and the tanks. Face there, planes. One plane will probably get out. Not sure about the others. fast forward. Takes forever. Some left. Try to send all the planes out and the tanks. And the infantry. Right, all our fighter planes have been taken out. So the Stuka is still in the air. They'll probably be taken out soon. seem to have one fighter plane in the air, but that's probably the AI reinforcement. Let's pause the game. And attack that unit of MiG-3 fighters. Seems to only be one, though. Should probably be taken out soon. Let's move the tank out if we can. All right, 68% allies killed, 49% enemies killed, so they are leading. I'm expecting the assault infantry to be taken out by the plane. They seem to be idiots. Let's move them out of AI control. And pause the game. Still in the air. Close victory! We managed to win somehow. Timer maybe. So Ferdinand von Bock has 664, man, he killed 201, which was pretty bad. Men remaining 263, half remaining, I see. and Captain Murad, Captain Arthur, second arm killed, 23, had 25, 15 remaining. Lost about half. Captain Murad had 449 men. Captain Murad of the Soviet Union had 449 men. Killed 539 and had 220 remaining. Detailed statistics. Alright, we managed to defend Prague. Question is if they will attack immediately again. Because then I think we are doomed. No, they didn't. Soviet Union have an army now on British territory here. Odessa is still held by our ally. Soviet Union took Budapest and not the Italian Empire. So they have taken most of Hungary now. The Italian Empire are still besieging Novi Sad. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. Soviet Union and the Italian Empire. That's very good. The following factions have broken their alliances. Japanese Empire and India. Alright. The following factions have declared they are allies. The United States of America and Portugal. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. The French Republic and the Italian Empire. End of turn report. We are good again with the economy. Faction announcements, we have some announcements there. Construction complete, we have an army headquarters in Berlin. We have new troops. It's a second too late. Or too early, yeah. The Soviet. They've gone through Hungary and taken their areas. Italy is pretty strong. And I've opened up another front there. The Eastern Roman Empire has reformed, but they still lack the Turkey area and the Middle East, of course. They have all of this. Lots of Soviet armies trespassing in our land too. Strong forces. Prague has been severely weakened after lost battle. Let's merge all the infantry units. Move the infantry from there. Leave the artillery might be good in a settlement with the brick wall. Good as defensive troops. Stettin first. bristle to Berlin. Ah, Spain has trespassed into our lands here. They have a full army. Messerschmitts, scout snipers. Mortars, yeah. Smooth is plane unit. Speak to all the allies here. Italian Empire.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Can't ally them.
Left click
for
on
some
an item
reason.
In the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty.
Speak to the French state witch then.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A ballot.
I think they already taken two areas here from the United States in Africa. They're still holding the island over here as well. I'm surprised the Soviet Union is trespassing on British territory there. So Prague needs one more unit. Could send a sniper unit there. That's probably a waste. Send an assault infantry unit.
Teilen die Einheiten des Reiches.
Let's send the assault infantry unit to this army here. Alright, let's see if we can build anything. Speedy training ground, 6 turns, 5 turns for the dockyard. 4 times for the aerodrome. Let's build an aerodrome in Berlin. It's time. Alright, and then the recruitment. We'll construct a Tiger One. As usual. Messerschmitt 109, fighter plane in Hamburg. Messerschmitt in all the places where I can get them. Frankfurt will get the U-88, of course. It's better. Messerschmitt in Amsterdam. And in Brussels. As well as in Paris. Bordax in Prague in Stettin, assault infantry in Copenhagen, and we're back in Berlin. I wanted to speak to the Spanish too. So go to the Spanish state and speak to them.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Map information.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treat.
So they have lost one area in Africa. No, they have two areas here. Or one fort, probably. One area. El Ayun is still held by Spanish state. I wonder if they will attack me with this army. I can easily take Bordax. They have the same fighter planes as we have. Same Stokes mortars. The Italian infantry. And the Italian scout snipers. Right. So So next turn. End turn. No one attacked this time. Faction destroyed. Thailand has been destroyed. So Japan or Britain is going hard over here. It's going strongly forward. I believe Japan is very big now. End of turn report. Still good economical faction announcements. Construction complete. München is now a city. So let's construct the farms. We already have them. And asphalt roads. Medium parks. And SS headquarters. Alright, let's construct a sandbag wall in München. Diplomatic information. The following factions have declared. The following factions are now at war with each other. Romania and the Soviet Union, that's perfect. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. The Italian Empire and the French Republic. Farms plus 2 has been completed. In München we have asphalt roads, medium park, and SS headquarters. So we have a city now. München is a city now. Aerodrome. Howitzer training ground, large concern. This is still helping Romania. Right. So we have family members there. The Italian Empire has taken Novi Sad from the rebels. Seven fighter planes in each of those cities. Stettin has a new full army of fighter planes. This unit could be moved to the army. Right, we have another plane. Could be moved towards the army. Believe that was from München. Spanish state might be about to attack the rich French. Don't know, but it looks like it. Here we have the Portuguese faction. Let's pick them. It was some time ago.
Left click on the listed offer and
things could have changed on the map.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
Yeah, they've lost one area in Africa to the rebels.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous
treaty. And the United States have taken an area from Vichy, France in Africa. This area. Nouakchott. Wonder if Italy will stand a chance against the Soviet Union. Soviet Union has pretty good tanks. So I'm not sure. But Italy has pretty good planes. Or the Italian Empire. They attack Prague again. Eight MiG-3s and one Yak-9 versus 4-6 versus 7 versus Mi-109 fighters there. They have the advantage. They have more fully sized units. I'm too tired to play. Too annoying to speak when I'm tired. Need to go and eat something. And after that probably sleep. Alright, I will pause here. See you soon.